Welcome to today's session. In this session, we are going to learn about mosQUIRIX. mosQUIRIX is a malarial vaccine, and the African nation of Malawi, which is seen here in the map, will be undertaking large-scale pilot tests for the world's most advanced experimental malarial vaccine, that is mosQUIRIX, in a bid to prevent the disease. The vaccine has been recommended by WHO for pilot introduction in selected areas of three African countries, which are Ghana, Kenya and Malawi. So in this context, let's understand about this vaccine in detail in today's session. Let's get started. So before we start learning about the vaccine, we need to understand how the malarial parasite actually enters into human body and how it affects humans, right? So in order to understand that, we need to understand a little bit about the life cycle of the malarial parasite. So let's look at the life cycle first. The causative organism of malaria is a parasite which is Plasmodium. Plasmodium causes malaria and it is spread by female Anopheles mosquitoes. Now let's look at the life cycle of Plasmodium. See, there are two phases, okay? One phase of the life cycle of Plasmodium happens within the body of the mosquito and the next phase happens in the body of humans. So in the body of mosquito, the Plasmodium is in the form of sporozoids, and when the mosquito goes and bites a human being, it introduces sporozoids into the human's body, and these sporozoids go and attack the liver cells, which are hepatocytes. So the sporozoids go and attack the hepatocytes and they multiply within the hepatocytes. You can see the multiplication here. And these hepatocytes, they contain lot of sporozoids, okay? And these sporozoids multiply within the hepatocytes or the liver cells, and they give rise to merozoids. See, you can see it here. The sporozoids in the hepatocytes become merozoids, and these merozoids go and attack red blood cells, okay? Merozoids go and attack red blood cells, and even in the red blood cells, merozoids keep multiplying, and lot of merozoids are formed in the red blood cells. After that, these become gametocytes, and at this stage, when the mosquito bites the human being and sucks the blood, these gametocytes get passed on into the body of the mosquito. And in the body of mosquito, again these gametes become zygote, zygote 2, kinate, then oocyst, and finally again they become sporozoids. So here you need to remember that the sporozoids in the body of mosquito gets transmitted into the humans when the mosquito goes and bites the human, and these sporozoids will continue the life cycle in the human being. And this is how the cycles will keep progressing. In the human body, when the life cycle of Plasmodium is actually happening, what happens here is, first the sporozoid goes and attacks the liver cell, then it ruptures the liver cell and merozoids come out, which merozoids go and attack the RBC. So when the merozoids multiply within the RBCs and lot of merozoids come out after the rupture of RBCs, no? Every time the RBCs rupture and merozoids are released, the symptoms of malaria can be seen in humans. Okay, the fever and the chills, all of this happens when the RBCs rupture and merozoids come out. That is when we can see the symptoms of malaria. So the rupture of RBC and coming out of the merozoids from the ruptured RBC shows the symptoms of malaria in human beings. Now coming to the details of the vaccine. See, this is the world's first vaccine against a parasitic disease. And the name of the vaccine is RTSS. Whereas its market name or trade name is mosQUIRIX. It uses antibodies to target proteins, okay? It targets proteins. Which proteins does it target? It targets those proteins which are presented by the sporozoids. See, if you remember from the last slide, sporozoid stage is the first stage of the malarial parasite or Plasmodium in the human body. So it targets that stage of Plasmodium, and it targets this protein, the circumsporozoid protein of Plasmodium falciparum. It is an engineered vaccine. Why is it called engineered? Because it was made using a hepatitis B viral protein and also a chemical adjuvant. See, why is a chemical adjuvant used? It is used to increase or enhance the immune response of the vaccine. Now let's look at the problem of malaria in Indian context. See, it is not just the problem of African countries. Even India falls in that category where there are a lot of malarial cases coming to the hospitals every year. So let's look at India's efforts in this regard. So India's progress in fighting malaria is an outcome of concerted efforts, and they have ensured that malarial program is country owned and country led. At the East Asia Summit in 2015, India pledged to eliminate malaria by 2030. And following this public declaration, India launched a 5-year national strategic plan for malaria elimination. See, here you need to understand that there is a marked shift from control to elimination. That means earlier we just wanted to control, whereas now we want to eliminate malaria altogether. And the plan provides a roadmap to achieve the target of ending malaria in 571 districts out of India's 678 districts by 2022. Now, in this context, let's look at one of the Indian state's initiatives to eliminate malaria. It is the initiative of Odisha government. It is called Daman, Durgama Anchalare Malaria Nirakaran. It aims to deliver services to the most inaccessible and the hardest hit people of the state of Odisha. And the initiative has inbuilt innovative strategies to combat asymptomatic malaria, where there are no symptoms. For that also, there is scope in this Daman initiative. And the program is jointly implemented by the ICMR, NIMR. ICMR is the Indian Council of Medical Research, and the National Institute of Malaria Research, National Vector-Borne Disease Control Program, the Odisha government, and the Medicines for Malaria Venture. With this, we have come to the end of today's session. Here, we have mentioned a few model questions. Please answer them. Hope you like this video. See you in the next video. Thank you.